Welcome back.
Today it is boat building day, but not as we know it.
So have you ever done boat building, fiberglass stuff before?
Apart from our roof, no.
What could possibly go wrong?
Let's get to work. So the idea with the hoe is try and fill as much as possible between the boat and the mould, and hopefully the boat will just float. Float your boat time! So, you know what they say about polishing a turd? That's what we're about to do.
Right, so I'm going to say, guess what time it is? It's paint your boat time!
That's all my hands. Oh, I don't like it!
Is it a bit tippy?
It's a bit tippy, can we put someone underneath it? I'm going to be painting. The painting's not going to go well, is it?
Don't go up there.
Well, I don't want to get it on the wood.
Get the bit she's missed. Our propulsion system. So apparently chicks dig guys with twin engine boats.
Well, everyone keeps saying we need more experience on twin engine boats.
Yeah.
So we're gonna make our tender twin engined electric outboards.
Twin electric, eh? So then we'll be able to slow it round, and yeah, it should be fun, shouldn't it? Mm.
But also, these have a remote control. So, can we use the tender to remove rubbish from the boat without us...
Unmanned?
An unmanned skip truck.
We can give it a try, can't we?
So these engines are boss as well because they're so light. Check it out. One-handed. Couldn't do that with your six horse, could you?
No.
So, shall we see if we can make an unmanned remote control tender, and will it get up on the plane with electric outboards? It may be the first.
That's our plan.
Let's go and give it a test.
Okay, so here's our little tender. Twin electric ThrustMe outboards, 1.5 horsepower each. So we've now got two of them, so they're now working in tandem. So as you can see, when I turn one, it turns the other, which I think is pretty cool. So yeah, we're going to give it a quick test. So you may as well test it on the road for the first ever test, because we've got such a lot of water. Should have an oar for this.
No, you're on the road, you're not in the sea.
There you go, it floats, don't I? That's how you drive these things.
So what we need to do now is see how far of a range have we got on the remote controls. So I've got one. We're going to leave Simon in the boat with the other one, so if we do lose the range, he can actually get himself back. So you will have to control the steering because I've only got one remote.
This isn't going to go wrong, is it? Do you know how to stop it?
No.
Stop. Forward now, then stop it. Right, you're moving forward. Right, reverse. Okay.
Right. Cool!
I'm letting it go on its own now. Alright, so I'm not doing anything. I'm just trying to keep it in a straight line.
It's vibrating at me!
It's going on!
It's just vibrating. Ah! So long, sucker!
Right, so you saw us testing it with these fobs doing, so going one forward, one backwards, or both forward. It was really, really cool. So it's fantastic controls. But what we need to be able to do is we need to be able to like drive it remotely. And these will only go up to like 70 meters, I think. We need to go a bit further than that, I think. So I've got a plan. So my plan is to power the ThrustMe is to use my radio control plane transmitter, and then technically we'll be able to then drive the boat when you stood on the ground or on surrender. So let's see if we can make this communicate with two of the electric outboards. So I've now opened up the ThrustMe outboard to have a look what's inside. So we've got a power supply, a charge cable, and what else have we got? We've got a volt sensor for each cell. Then this one has turned out to be the speed controller. So when we give it an input from the throttle here, so you go forward or stop and then reverse and stop, that sends a signal down here to the speed controller, which the speed controller is in the leg down here, through these cables here. So what we've now realized is that if we use our receiver, which is originally off a model plane, the control voltage for this is 3.2 volts and the control voltage for these receivers are 5 volts. So to power the receiver, we've now got a USB power supply. So at the moment I've just got it connected to my bench supply. So that then receives, then sends the relevant signals to the speed controller and then allows it to work. So let's give it a try. So we can now control the throttle now from the transmitter. That's way cool, isn't it? So you're not really supposed to run these out of the water because technically the motor could overheat, but we're just giving it a little burst. So right, well now we need to try and make it pretty, don't we? Because we need reliability, don't we? Exciting! So we've got the motors back on the hull now, and we've got our wires plumbed into them, so we can now manipulate the speed controller that's already inside the motors. So now we need like a central box for the receiver to go in. So in this box as well, it's going to have a little camera, so we can actually see where the boat's going from a remote location, so like FPV. So we're going to mount it around here somewhere. So now we need to work out like the cable lengths. Box is going to go around there. Let's get to making the box. There we go. So these are going to be connected. So this is going to be like, say, the port engine and the starboard engine. So should plug them both onto the motors now through this little box, and we can see if they go forwards and backwards.
So today we've come to Gresford Sailing Club, to their model boat club that they have going on a Saturday. And I checked the website, there was no size restrictions for the model boat club. So we're going to give it a test on the lake.
Maximum people, zero. Maximum people, one underway, zero.
Right, should we get it in and see if it's going to work?
Yeah, go on.
Oh, hold on. Simon's missing something.
leather.
Captain's hat on.
I trust Simon to remote control me around the lake and I'll throw me in. Right, I'm gonna be brave.
Be slow.
Yeah.
It's really strange being in a boat, someone else is controlling.
Bye.
Look after me. This is cool.
Well, she's definitely cracked this, hasn't she? First she was a bit jittery on the sticks and now she's like beautifully controlled.
So to pass your test you have to come and like bring it alongside here without touching it. Look if you can do it.
Yeah.
Touched it! Still good, very good though.
This is ace. Do you want to get in and I'll take you for a spin?
Not really. I kind of hate my wife. She's like, she just picks up everything dead quick. It's like, yeah, go on, let's
get
go for
in.
A spin.
Hi.
I'm sure you could automate this. You could like go, right, take me here. So as many of you know, I'm not a massive fan of like electric cars and stuff like that, but these electric outboards have really opened my eyes. They're amazing. So lightweight, so much power, but yeah, absolutely fantastic. If you want an ultra lightweight outboard that you can, I can hold them both out of my arms like that, highly recommended. Fantastic.
Thrust me all the way.
Thrust me, yeah, yeah.
So I think that is what you call a success.
Yeah. That went a lot better than I expected.
We wanted an electric tender that would be fully remote control and up on the plane.
Yeah, and FPV so we can see where it's going.
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished, well done.
I've got too much stuff in my hands. So, do you think now when we're at surrender we can do rubbish removals without anyone manning the boat?
Easy.
That's the next big test. Yeah. Right, thanks for watching.
Cheers, guys.
See you next time.
See you next time.